Removing hair from raised moles on the face is usually easy and safe. But if the mole is removed, will that prevent the hair from growing back? It depends on how the mole is removed. Hello, I'm Dr. Neil Schultz, and welcome to DermTV. I've explained why removing hair from facial moles is usually safe. But raised moles on the face usually aren't desirable. And when they have hair, if I tell you that some people call them grandmother moles, that should be enough to explain why people often have them removed. So you would think that removing the mole would ensure that the hair won't grow back. Well, not exactly. You see, it depends on how it's removed. And for that to make sense, you have to go back to what is a mole with hair. Moles with hairs, regardless of where they are on your body, are usually intradermal moles. Intra means within, and dermal means the second layer of skin. So this is our favorite diagram of the skin. And here, the epidermis is exploded away from the dermis, but the border between the epidermis and the dermis is this wavy line. Now, I have to ask you to promise not to laugh at my artwork, but this is supposed to be a diagram of the same thing. So we have the epidermis, this is the top of your skin, and this wavy line is the border between the upper epidermis and the lower dermis, and of course we have our mole. So intradermal moles are entirely in the dermis, the second layer of skin. The fact that it sticks up above the surface of your skin and is a bump, don't forget, this is the layer of our skin, this is the mole sticking up and it's a bump, it means that there's a lot of mole tissue in the dermis pushing up on the unaffected top layer of the epidermis, which is present even on top of the mole. So if my epidermis is here, it doesn't stop here, it curls right around on top of that mole, this thin layer of epidermis. But check out where the hair roots are. If the hair root is down here, then it's really below the level of the epidermis. And if the hair root is up here, it's above the level of the surrounding epidermis. Now, there are two ways to remove the mole. The technique that gives us the best cosmetic result is by simply using a scalpel blade to shave off the raised part of the mole. Yes, of course I use local anesthesia, so it's painless. So in that case, what I've done is I've removed all the part of the mole that's above this line. This technique usually gives the best cosmetic result with no scar. But don't forget where the hair follicles are located. So if your hairs are growing from follicles up here, above where the cleavage level is, then those hairs are gone and they won't come back because they're part of the mole that we took off. But what if the hairs are down here? If the hairs are growing from down here, then after we've removed this part, those hair follicles are still present. So they're going to continue to grow. Okay, so why not cut out the entire mole, even the part under the skin, so all the hair roots and follicles are removed? Because to do that, I need to cut out all the skin. What I need to do is I have to cut down to here, I have to start here, cut down to here, underneath, and come all the way around, and sew the two sides together. Even with the best skill and technique, whether it's done by a plastic surgeon or a cosmetic dermatologist, it can leave a scar. So when it comes to having facial moles with hairs removed, do you really have to pick your poison? No scar, but possible ongoing growth of hairs? Or no more hairs, but a possible scar? Not at all. Just get it removed the first way. And if your hair continues to grow, then you can finally have those remaining hairs destroyed by laser or electrolysis. Please join me again at DermTV.com. If you have a question, please send it to me by visiting DermTV.com/question. I'm Dr. Neil Schultz, and thank you for watching today.